All right, today I'm going to show you how to install the Dalton Clutch Kit on a 21 or newer Commander vehicle at hand. For us is a 22 Commander XMR. We chose this vehicle. It doesn't apply to you, it applies to everybody else with Can-Ams, but we chose this particular vehicle because it shares the same clutches as several models and allows us to do testing, tools, belts, videos, etc. for several models. You hit the home run here because you have the actual vehicle we're doing the actual clutch kit on. Now, I will say this particular clutch kit video, I've already installed my clutch kit, so I'm going to be uninstalling it on camera and reinstalling it. So just be warned of that and any little odd transitions here because of that. So let's get on with the clutch kit install. As mentioned, we're going to move on to the clutch kit install. Before we get started, just remember that this particular kit is the Commander. The clutches are so similar, there's a few little minor differences, but you can use the process on all these vehicles that I mentioned. And we separated, you know, three different videos to make it clear. But don't panic if your X3 or your Maverick Trail or your Maverick Sport R doesn't have the exact same stuff. Follow your kit instructions. Process is all the same. Okay, so the first thing you're going to need to do is separate the governor cup or the two halves of the clutch from the other. So hopefully you're going to be using a clutch puller from Hunter Works, and you're going to screw it in. As soon as it touches the threads, I'm an impact guy. About so far down, leave about a half inch or so between the nut portion and this. Pick up your tool. Hopefully it's the Hunter Works Made in the USA tool. You can find one no better. Get all your screws started in the clutch. These do not have to be really that tight. I like, again, impact. Run it down. You're just trying to hold it in place. All right, now then we're gonna turn this nut down. It's a 15/16. You can use a ratchet, pull handle, whatever, hold on to this. Again, I'm an impact guy. Woo, pow! I wouldn't suggest unscrewing this all the way, because over time, if you use this tool a lot, the threads will get damaged and on the very bottom where it meets the puller, so there's never a need to pull it all the way out. Very expensive tool, I get it, but it's high quality. Share it with a buddy, but it's just needed, okay? And we're gonna take that back out. Again, I'm gonna use this 3/4 to speed it up. Okay. Now, we're able to take the governor cup off. Now with this, there are going to be three O-rings in here. Now another thing you need to do before we pull it off, you need to mark it. Mine's probably already marked from previous. I got multiple marks. So mark it with a black marker so you can put it back in the same place. And I would put it over somewhere in the middle of a table so that when you get this off and any of the, I call them spider buttons, any of those come out or move, then and you can find them. If you're lucky, they'll stay in, but I don't think we're gonna be lucky. Ooh, we are lucky. Mine stayed in. Yours may not. There's some O-rings under three of them that when they fall out, you gotta make sure those O-rings are in place. There's one right there. So let's bring it onto the camera. There are three that have this. And check for damaged O-ring, make sure it's in the right place when we go back here in a minute, but that's where it goes, okay? So I'm gonna lay that to the side. I would say this would be a great time, overhead view here, to look at these slide pieces. If they got wear when we go back, I would set it on a different one. Mine has a T-tiny bit only because this is a brand new vehicle. I'm still going to rotate this to a new side when I put it back. Okay, that one just fell out when I did that. So now we can move this to the spring compressor. Okay, There's another one fell out. It's vibrations doing it. Hopefully the Hunter Works spring compressor. And then handle on. Okay, now you're not doing any compressing at this point, so don't just keep cranking this thing. You'll bend it, tear stuff up. We're gonna get the proper bit for this. I believe that's it, a T30. Make sure you put some downward pressure because the tool didn't always let you get a direct downward angle. There it goes. Okay, take this remaining two screws out. Probably would not be the worst idea to mark that same position. So you can put it back, put your black mark before you pull it out, so you can put it back in the same spot. All this is not 100% required, just excellent idea for balance sake. If they put it in there like that, let's put it back like that. Okay, this particular clutch already has the Dalton clutch kit in it, so I am actually adjusted mine. But anyway, so we just took out a stock spring, and far springs go, we'll just hit it right now. Take the if your kit, I believe all the kits covered, these vehicles will have primary spring, and they're typically going to have a plastic washer in there. It's explained in the instructions what the washer does for you, and you put it in. So you can put it in now and put it in later, either way. Alright, so then again, every kit's going to be different. So I'm going to the three that are adjustable and I'm removing them. Takes T25 bit on one side and a 8mm or 5/16, I believe, on the other. Okay, I know I'm opposite of the camera, but I'm just taking a bolt pivot pin out, okay? Now, my kit has washers in it, and I gotta be mindful of not losing them. I'm trying to remember about the stock weights. I don't believe they had anything, but if they did, don't lose them, okay? So you're going to be taking out the three that are adjustable. If you have the three adjustable kit, or if this is the actual commander, you're going to take all six out. So I'm just going to skip on in the video till I get them all out. We'll talk about it in a sec. Okay, now that depending on your vehicle, you got all six out, none out, three out. So since I've already done the three on this commander kit, we're just gonna do the three that are adjustable. And FYI, the stock weights do not have the little washers, so that's not something you'll keep up with, but you will install with the new weights. All right, so you read your instructions. It's got setup sheets in here to tell you what to do and how to set it up. In my case, I'm gonna be using a 3/8 set screw in the tip, and you're gonna take your set screws. I got them laid out here on the table with the gold screws. I'll move them out of the way, and I'm gonna put a tiny bit of blue Loctite on them. I said tiny, it's hard to get a little amount out, okay? And I'm gonna get rid of some of that. Okay, and we're gonna screw in from this side, not this flat side, but this side right here. I should have probably put it on the tool. It would have been easier to get in than my fat fingers, okay? So repeat the set screw call for in each weight, and then we'll put them in. Okay, now we're ready to put them in, and I'll try to do one from this angle so you can see better on the install part. Okay, so our pivot pins are all running this way. Grab the black washers that come with it. And I like to hang that washer right on the end of that thread. Put my weight in there. All right, this is gonna be the fun part for me because I can't hardly do it backwards and I'm used to doing it. And set your other washer in there. There it went. Put your nut on. I would put just a tad of blue Loctite on. Get it started with your fingers. Take your same tool. I'm certainly going to do this upside down. Can't do it upside down. Sorry. I'm sure there's a torque spec on that, but I don't use it. If you want to be a torque spec nerd, and I'm kidding, of course, do, but seems like on some of these smaller screws, bolts, and stuff, when people start trying to torque them, they'll get foot pounds and inch pounds messed up, or their torque wrench is not calibrated, and you just run into all kind of problems. And if you'd have just tightened it down till it stopped, it is a lock nut, plus we're putting a little bit of blue Loctite on it anyway. It's not like it's going to go anywhere. This is not what I would consider a critical area. There's certainly some areas that have critical bolts. I'm just, that's not one of them to me. Okay. Sorry, I know this video is gonna be a little long, but you know, it's an expensive kit, expensive vehicle. If you want things done right and you want a good quality kit, I would just suggest painstakingly watch this whole thing. All right, so got all them back in. Now we're gonna put our spring from the kit in. This is probably the proper time. This washer here is just simply allows the spring to not grab the cup and try to torsion at the same time. It allows it to spin in the cup and just for more efficient operation, if you will, okay? I have a reason for leaving mine out. Do not leave yours out. I'm testing something else for somebody else, so don't do what I do here, okay? Absolutely put yours in. Now, where's our mark at? Here's our mark. And then now it's time to use the old HunterWorks spring compressor. Start that compressing. Don't go all the way down. Get it close, because you're gonna have to line it up. Get it close enough that you can get all your screws in, and we're gonna put a little blue Loctite on them as well. Now, while I'm setting these screws in, these do have a torque spec on them. Torque on these are 89 inch pounds. I do not own an inch pound torque wrench, so this is gonna go off my experience. And again, I don't think this is one of those super critical areas. I think torquing them on the vehicle is certainly critical on these. And a HunterWorks holding tool works great for that. Make sure they're all in the hole. Be gentle if you're using an impact. You can tell when it's not threaded right. They all are. Come on down. All right, bottomed out. Now we do a crisscross pattern. That was 8, that was 89 inch pounds or whatever. All right, crisscross. All right, now we can take that compressor back off. All right, now it's time for that governor cup. If you have new O-rings for these buttons. Now is the time to put them in. I've got two buttons that fell out. Like I said, we're going to rotate these to a good one in case you have any wear. That's a good one. That looks like one I've used or was using. All right, so let's find, well, here's the way to do this actually, is do one. I'll show you, here we go. So if it's that one and that one, it's gonna be this one, okay? So make sure you hold that one together. Find your marks. Mine is right here, and then this is gonna be an odd, but I want you to put it in and put that one in first, okay? Just at an angle. You'd probably be better off at this point getting it off of here. All right, so we're gonna put it in at an angle and then barely have it in. And you're gonna take this O-ring, make sure it's in the proper spot. There's a little groove for it in there. Make sure it's all in there correct. And then you're gonna ease down on that one, okay? Now, see that leaves our last one. And you gotta be careful and be easy and slow. Make sure it goes in there correct. You don't get it pinched. Put your button in. It has a position flat on the bottom. All right. You can tell when that O-ring is not in there right. It just won't feel right. All right. I believe I got her. And that O-ring behind those three is to kind of tighten this up to help control some noise. And when you go back, one thing you probably should have done, and so hopefully watch this and you're not doing step by step. When we mark this, it would have been a great idea to mark it across the square or with the bottom half also. But I will say this. Since you can buy a back half, front half, and governor cup all separate, then it's probably not that important to have them all exactly back. It's just a good practice to do it. But when you can buy different pieces, that means they've been balanced separately. So it's not as critical. But still, yet a good idea, okay? Now, you're through. But here's the kicker. It's a good idea to hold it together, because it can come back apart. It won't stick until it's back on the vehicle. Vehicle's behind the camera. So I would do this, and I would take brake clean, clean rag, Scotch-Brite pad, whatever, scrub it up, clean it up, wipe it down. Probably better off doing it while it was apart. I just kind of forgot about it to now. And then once you do that, don't even put your fingers on it anymore. Just stay away from it. At this point, you go to our other video where we're reinstalling it. You hold it all together and get it on the crankshaft. If you don't hold it like this, it will come apart and you'll just have a mess. May break something, okay? So, primary is done. We will move to the secondary clutch. All right, my clutch already has a Dalton in it, but it's gonna be fine for this purpose. I have the OE here. If you need some information, it's sitting right there for us, okay? All right, now this is gonna be just a little bit of a trick, but this is another great use of the Hunter Works holding tool, and this is a great way to use it, okay? And you'll see as we proceed on. So whether it be your stock Helix or your Dalton has these additional holes. So what I would do at this point, let's get our holding tool in a hole. And then we're going to set it on the compressor. Make sure you have the washer we send with it. And set it down on here. Okay. Now, on the stock one, this is raised and that washer sit right in there. Okay. So I put a screw over where my finger is through this hole. And you're gonna see here in just a moment how all this comes together and why.
It has two purposes. Alright. Get that centered there.
Okay, now we're gonna switch to our bit on our big one to a T50 or ratchet, but T50. This is a tough one.
Mine's kind of loose because I don't
have any Loctite, and it's just been out a couple days ago when I was doing my own kit, doing some testing for Dalton. Okay. FYI, a lot of people don't know this, we're not just seller Dalton, we're probably their biggest U.S. customer, and we're good friends, and we help each other in the background to make better and great parts. So once those three are out, here's the thing is, and this thing is, the spring is torsion, so you're going to want to hold on to it so it doesn't just come loose on you and scare you. So just hold on, squeeze, and hold as you take the pressure off that spring. That tool is holding that helix in place and it's locked in over here, okay? All right, I feel it trying to twist on me, so, and then it's probably gonna make a little noise as it really comes out right here at the end. There went the top one, it's free, and it's fixing to want to turn on me, so just, all right, there you go. Now, the thing too is it's a good idea to mark things, but you can't mark on yours because you ain't gonna reuse it. Your sheave has arrows on it. We'll get to that in a minute. All right. Set this to the side. And set this to the side. Now, we'll say, if you haven't bought any, already, now is a great time, even though I get the expense of our rollers and our USA made tool we had, it's pretty slick, but now's a good time to swap out the OE rollers to our better rollers. Okay, watch that video. So then we're going to take our helix and spring cup out. Of course, you'd be taking off your OE helix and your OE spring out. I've got the Dalton, and we're going to go back with it, okay? Now, Dalton says to put the Tang in number 4, okay? All right, so when you get ready to go back, I would take a marker. Now, you'll see why in a minute, to go where is number 4, okay? It's right there, putting right on the side of there. Now, we're going to go down, and we're going to put the pins in vacant holes, okay? Number 4 is all the way over here. And put the Tang in the hole. Now's a good time, while your clutches are off, to take some brake clean, Scotch-Brite pad, and clean these belt surfaces up, and then go back together. So it's time to put our secondary back together. We got it cleaned up. We want to get our Tang, make sure it's in number 4 hole, it's here. We're gonna set our clutch roller side down and set it down in Tang in the hole again. Our mark for our arrow is up front. A mark for our this one is gonna be front to me. We're gonna line it up, okay? Now when you look down in here, the bolt holes do not match yet. And that's because we gotta do some twisting. That's where you're gonna see this Hunter Works holding tool comes in like a champion. Try to do it without. It's like wrestling a damn bear. Okay, now, one thing I learned is hopefully you got a little belly because you're fixing to use it, okay? So at this point, we're gonna turn it because this spring has to be torsioned. And if you put too much of this on there, you can't get the roller over the top of the helix. It's like I did, see here. All right, now, they're rolling right on top of the helix. And it went down. Here's where that belly comes in. Now, without this holding tool, trust me, when I was doing these kits before I even realized our tool would work for this, I was like, God, I'd hate to have to put one of these kits in on a regular basis. So anyway, makes the work easy. We'll come on down. get it pretty close. We're gonna put some blue Loctite on these. Once again, I lathered it up really well. I don't know why I'm having such a hard time just getting a little bit out. All right, make sure they're in the hole. Don't worry, I'm not impacting these. I'm just getting them started. All right, now we're gonna compress, okay? All the way down till the bottom's out. All right, we're good to go there. Oh, all right, I'm cheating. I'm gonna bottom them out. Now we're gonna torque these bolts down. We're gonna torque them down to 45 foot-pounds, 45. Here's where that holding tool comes in handy, makes this a one-hand operation. All right. Okay. And you're done. Our spring is right, our roller's in the right slot. Everything's lovely. This kit is installed, ready to go back on the vehicle. Use our video showing you how to remove and install primary clutches. And again, on the primary, remember, don't let go. Don't forget, we got the best belt on the planet. I will add this, if you're putting a new belt of any kind, hopefully it's a 100 Works belt, but when you do a clutch kit and a new belt at the same time, one of the things that you can expect is a lower shift phase RPM than what it will be once it gets 200 or 300 miles on it. I like to add that if you're gonna have to do any adjusting on the clutch weights, if you do not purchase this tool, I forget what it costs, 40, 50 bucks. If you do not purchase this, then you're going to be pulling a primary, using a governor cup tool and all of that just to make an adjustment to a clutch when you can buy this and right on the vehicle, you screw this down in here. It separates the two halves, kind of for you, moves this down where you can get access to your fly weight, get it out, make adjustments, go back. So check that out too. So as this is obviously a showcase of our tools, Dalton Clutch Kit, which is the best on the planet, and in our belt, in our opinion, best on the planet for these as well. So if you got any tech questions on this or any questions, anything I was unclear of, then feel free to email me, Todd@HunterWorks.com. Make sure you subscribe, like, tell your friends. Thank you.